Right, this video is mostly for Smurf collectors. I don't know if you know much about collecting older Smurfs, more interesting Smurfs, but today I did pick up a little lot of Smurfs. I also got some ET stuff, and I got that wind-up Smurf. That's pretty rare. You don't see that too often. But I did say in the beginning of this video that today I was going to show you what would be pretty much the holy grail, the rarest of rarest of all the Smurfs out of this little collection I have here. And I don't know. Obviously, it's not like the white ball shooting Smurf. I'm not really sure what generic sport this would be. I would have said basketball, but it looks kind of like a mothball. So maybe that's what Smurfs play their basketball with, mothballs, which is probably not, well, at least Smurfs are not like moths. Mothballs will not kill them, so that's good to know. Here we have like Peeping Tom Smurf. He would actually be watching Smurfette, not so much while she was rollerblading. I do have a rollerblading Smurf, but normally he would be behind a window or a tree peeking out and watching Smurf while she was like changing her Smurf costume. Like normally Smurfette wouldn't be wearing a rollerblading costume, so he would probably just be waiting for her to he probably does this from a boat, or you know what, it's actually probably a good idea if you were to be a Peeping Tom to dress like the captain of a boat, so then most people would not think anything of it. They would be like, oh, he's a captain of a boat and he's looking for land. Land ahoy. You know. But no, that isn't it. Again, it's not the lasso roping a cowboy Smurf looking to probably tie up and steal the land of some Indians or something like that. No, it's not him. Oh, this is more of a generic Smurf. They do not have the Indian Smurf, I believe. So he would be, I guess, the Kemosabe Smurf. They do not have a Tonto Smurf. And here's just your standard, like, nothing Smurf. He's just, I don't know what I to do or what I'm supposed to be. I don't even have a shirt. It's like, and here's my tail popping. I mean, if a Smurf were to be pooping, that would probably be, maybe this is the, like, learning how to poop. No, because he has a beard, so no, he's a full-on adult Smurf. No, I would say, and again, it's also not the, walking around in the non-winding, non-walking around Smurf. Let me see if I try. Yeah, he doesn't really appear to be to do anything at all. Plus, he has some kind of weird facial scarring. No, I would say the rarest of the rare, the most highly sought after and collected, are the very dirty, steroid Smurf set. And as you could see, there is the nurse. She has prepared the Smurfette nurse Smurfette. She has prepared the steroid injection for the bodybuilder. He's here at the doctor's. It's probably not a real doctor's office, but she does like to pretend. See, she has the clipboard. How many shots of steroids will she have to give today? And he's like, why are you so dirty? She's like, shut up. I'm here to give you the steroids. Don't worry, the steroids are clean. And he's like, okay. She is here to give him the steroids. And he's like, I'm feeling weaker already. I used to be able to lift this barbell set with one finger. I used to balance it on my pinky finger because the steroids had made me very strong, but I am feeling weaker. So she's like, well, okay. She does drink, apparently, and the booze makes her wobbly. Oh, look, there's some hair on her, some very light white pubic type hair. But this particular Smurf is like, as you could see, my muscles are fading. My leg is getting weak. I'm starting to just collapse under the weight of the left, the right side of my body. So could you hurry up and give me a steroid injection? And she's like, sure, where would you like it? And he says, well, I heard that if you do steroids, everybody that takes the steroids in the butt, right, It makes their testicles shrink. So maybe if you put the steroids straight into my testicles, they would make them large and muscular, like myself. So she would probably be like, I don't give a shit. Sure, why not? And then she would just inject him with the non-testicle shrinking steroids right in straight into his testicles, like probably through the both of them, like sideways. But when he would be finished, you know, since she probably has some left, right? And I think it's okay to share needles. I don't think there's a problem sharing hypodermic needles between Smurfs, because I don't think they're known very much for diseases like herpes or hepatitis or syphilis. I don't believe that's a common problem amongst Smurfs. So after he would be done, he'd be like, wow, I'm feeling much stronger already. So I guess I'll just kind of get out of here. But then the football Smurf would come, and you know, he would be recommended, of course, by the weightlifters. You should go there. They're giving out steroid shots. And he'd be like, okay. But then he would say, whoa, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait, is that, ouch, that's sharp. He's like, I don't really like needles. You know, I didn't know that you'd be stabbing me with such a large needle. Look, the needle is basically the size of my arm. Very, like, you know, how much steroids do I need so I can, like, play football better? I don't even play professionally. I just dress like this and run around. I'm not even a football player. And she's like, you know, I got other stuff to do. I have a life. You know, I just had a Smurf baby. He's at home screaming. I'm trying to make money selling these drugs, these illegal drugs, to guys like you. So I can buy, like, the kid likes Slim Jims. You know, that's his favorite thing to eat. So he's like, oh, all right, look, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to delay you or your baby. Where is the baby? She's like, I don't know. I left him behind a rock. I put the rock on top of him so he wouldn't blow away in the wind. Or if a wild animal came along, it would be harder for him to drag the baby away. And maybe I lose an arm or leg, but I still got most of the baby, which is pretty good, right? And he's like, okay, well, I'll just turn around, and you stick me wherever you want to stick me. And she was like, well, look, the other guy wanted to be stuck through his testicles. He's like, no, that's okay. My testicles are very small, and I only have one, because the last time I got my steroids injection, I believe you stuck me in the testicles, but only one, and then it got infected and fell off. And then someone thought it was a blueberry and ate it. She'd be like, okay, fine, I'll just stick you in your tail, right? Because your tail is vestigial, I think, which means probably that it doesn't do anything. It's like, is that something like if a Smurf is happy and they had to wear the tails? I don't believe so. I don't know about that. So he's like, yeah, go ahead, stick me in this useless piece of crap, right? And she did. And then he's like, whoa, these steroids are some pretty good stuff. I think I'm going to be able to, I haven't been able to throw this ball around. I'm very weak, right? But I think I'm going to be strong enough to throw the ball. And then I'm going to be a bully and push people over with my pushing hand. Take that, Santa, you stupid pencil sharpening jerk. And then here, phone this home. You got beat up by a Smurf. And give me your beer. Or don't turn it around, and whatever, all of you guys, and just shut up and get out of here. And that's, oh, and look, it's a very, I also did not mention that I also have the very rare T-E-T, the T-Girl E-T. That's phoning, I don't know. But anyway, yeah, so this very, very rare Smurf set is probably worth at least $3. But I'm not going to sell it, because maybe in 50 years it'll go up in value and it'll be worth more like $10. Anyway, I think you've learned enough about Smurfs for today. If you do ever see this set, don't bother me with your bunch of stupid questions about, like, you know, when it was made and stuff like that, because it's not like I'm a freaking Google, you know. Google, that's what Google is for. So use Google. Otherwise, I guess I'm out of here. Goodbye, guys. Goodbye. Goodbye. I still got some more this stuff left. How about I inject you in your eye? I heard that it's good to inject steroids in your eyes because it makes your eyes stronger. So how about I try that? I just inject you in your eye. I'm blind. Okay.